Hi guys, today we are going to look at runtime environment storage organization. So while execute the program, any language, be it C, Python, any language, while program is executed, what's happening internally, internal memory, what is happening? This is runtime storage environment. What are all the way it starts communicating? What are all the way information is stored? For example, as I mentioned in the previous class, one story. You and me, we can travel anywhere. Morning, we can step out of house. The moment we step out of the house, we can go to mall, we can go to temple, we can come to college, we can visit our friend's house. After moving so many places, safely we can return back to our home because we remember the address of our home or our residence, how exactly we need to reach something. Whereas in the programming, the flow of execution is sequential, one after another. It is executing. All of a sudden, there is a transfer in call or transfer in execution, alteration in execution through either inbuilt function or user defined function or go to label. You will go there and go to label, what will happen? No, it will start executing in that sequence only. Whereas functions, inbuilt function, what are all the inbuilt function and user defined function, whenever these kind of functions comes into the picture of your programming, what will happen? Normally the program is executed main line number instruction 1, instruction 2, instruction 3, instruction 4. All of a sudden there is a function call. It can be anything, either inbuilt function or user defined function. Then instruction 5 or instruction 6, 7, etc. So you have function here. So now how the program is executing is what the point of discussion. See, whenever you are executing, you wanted to execute instruction 1, by that time itself you need to understand something. So what are all those stuff you need to understand is, while executing any instruction, that it is called program counter, PC. This program counter is responsible for loading the address of the next instruction to be executed. Instruction to be executed. Whichever the instruction is ready for execution, any instruction, it is ready for execution, then the address of the next instruction you have into the memory before even one small component you need to understand. The entire RAM is decomposed into instructional memory 1, data memory.
Ma'am,
next.
Ma'am,
yeah,
not sharing the screen, ma'am.
Not sharing the screen, ma'am. One minute, I try. Actually, several stuff I have written. Let me try now. What is happening? Okay, now it is it visible? Runtime environment storage organization, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So these are all the stuff I have written. That's all. Guys, disconnect, internet disconnect, screen, 1 minute. Please acknowledge, is it visible runtime storage again?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am, thank you. Now, see, whenever program is executed, how internal memory is utilized, how it is executing, all about internal execution mechanism is called runtime environment or storage organization. Very first point you need to understand. While your program is executing, what's happening inside? Almost compiler design is the subject will give you answer for what is happening inside whenever you are executing a program. You should understand how it is happening. You are writing a program, logical thinking is fine, but internally what's happening, how it is executing. You are writing a program, a human-like language, English, but how machine is understanding, how exactly it is accepting your input and it is giving back the expected output or some wrong output, whatever. Wrong output also it needs to process something. Now, how that process is happening? That is what your understanding happens now. If you look at inbuilt function, before inbuilt function, I want to tell one more concept. That is RAM memory. Internally, the RAM memory or running memory or executable memory, these all those memory, how it is devised or the compartments are available, different compartments. Although it is RAM, it has several compartments. Instructional memory. What is this memory is, it will start storing all the instructions. Your program finally converted into machine readable instruction. That is what the last phase of compiler. Instruction, machine code generator. Final, the last phase is machine code generator. So that code, all machine codes are loaded into instructional memory. Only then it can start executing your program. Normally in the RAM memory, the moment you switch on your laptop, what will happen is loadable memory. There is a loadable memory will be there. In that memory, automatically that loadable memory will fetch and bring your operating system. So there are several memory designated for certain activity. Each and every memory location have got some specific reason. There are memory accessible during the programming execution by the user. So in that manner, you need to understand the RAM memory itself divided into several components. One is instructional memory, next is data memory, another one is stack memory, another one is heap memory, and extra memory. These are all the kind of memory components you need to have into 1 minute. You need to, it is available. These are all the types of memory available. When to use what memory is the point of understanding you need to have next. Instructional memory is useful for holding all the executable code. What is the meaning of executable code? Otherwise, it is called machine code. Your program is finally translated as executable code or machine code. The program which you have written may be sum of two numbers. Fine. That sum of two number need to be converted into executable code form or machine code form. These codes are loaded into the memory location called instructional memory. Next, data memory. This is the memory related to your data. What is the meaning of data? All your input, the temporary variable, symbolic data. This is the memory your symbol table is available. Right now we are talking about symbol table. This is what the purpose of symbol table. Next, stack memory. This will be used during the function call invocation. During function call invocation, it will be used. Whenever function call is happening, either inbuilt function call or user memory function call. So these again, heap memory, extra memory, these all depending upon the architecture, it will be used. Now, today we are going to discuss about this and this, instructional memory and stack memory. Instructional memory, there is a concept called program counter. This program counter only can communicate with instructional memory in order to read the instruction. It will read the instruction from the instructional memory. So these two are bundled together. What is the use of this program counter? Only PC can communicate to the CPU. CPU hierarchy among all the component of computer, CPU has the highest power of execution. Our speed, the speed of processing is unimaginable compared to all other components, we can say. The according to the executional speed, the first component is CPU, next is RAM. Before even RAM, what are all other component? That hierarchy you can read later. So underneath you can say cache memory, after cache memory stack memory, after stack memory RAM memory, after RAM memory only hard disk, these all those things. Since it is high speed of handling things, PC only can communicate. So any instruction you want to get done by CPU, you want to process it, you want to do something, you are in the support of PC, program counter. Without program counter, you can't do anything. So that is what first step you need to understand. So what is this program counter doing? It will load the address of memory, every instruction from the instructional memory. It is a normal RAM memory only. It will have 2008, 2005, 2007, that address. Either 16-bit address or 32-bit address, depending upon the configuration of your machine. So from that address location, whatever is available, it will fetch and it will feed to CPU. So this is what it is doing. So finally, your programming execution success is dependent upon how PC is communicating with your program and how PC is communicating with your CPU. That you need to understand very well. Next, data memory, all the input output constants, temporary variables are residing in the symbol, in the form of symbol table into data memory. What is stack memory is what? Now the discussion going to be started. Look at here, stack memory. This is useful during the function call invocation. As I mentioned earlier, I1, I2, I3, I4 sequentially executed. Program counter sequentially will fetch the address of this, will fetch the address of this instruction, this instruction, this instruction, and it will feed those instructional code to the CPU. CPU will start executing. That is fantastic. Fine. Now, what is this function call? All of a sudden, there is a function call. Alteration in the flow of execution. No more next instruction will be executed. The moment it sees function call, what will happen is call will be transferred to yet another location. This location, it will be transferred. So meanwhile, after this function, it should here also you will have instruction. One instruction, two, you will have, you notice any language, olden language or new language, for every function, you could able to see the keyword mandatorily written. Without written, it is not possible to return back to this line. So at the moment function call comes, control is transferred to here. The moment it sees the written, control is going back to here. That is fantastic. How it is possible is the question. We are talking easily, but how it is possible? Control is altered from there to here. Then the moment it is sees the return, the control is going back to there. How it is possible is the point of discussion. Now we are going to see runtime storage environment, one of the major concepts. The moment it sees the function call, it will create activation record. Or otherwise it is called frame pointer. These are all those concepts important for gate exam as well as activation record or frame pointer. What is this activation record is? It will create address of the next instruction to be executed. Now from this instruction, the control is transferred to here. The once the return function is executed, it needs to go back to the next instruction. Frame pointer consists of address of next instruction. This is number one point. Mainly you need to remember this first. Rest all is optional. Flags, status of flags. Internally, several flags are available. Every flag is meant for indicating sign flag, overflow flag, then carry flag. So there are several sign flag, several flags are available. Flag is a 1-bit register, a tiny register, a tiny buffer, we can say. So collection of flags. So these all status will go. Collection of that status of registers. What is the meaning of register is? Program counter will hold address of next instruction to be executed. PC only can communicate with the CPU, I said. Similarly, one more thought process you should have. Data memory. Then who will feed the data to the CPU? You may be doing sum of two number. That's fine. So it can give instruction that addition process need to be started. But who will give that data? A and B. That A and B are taken from the data memory or from the symbol table by the registers. All the registers are either 16-bit, 32-bit, 64-bit. Nowadays, more advanced registers have come. Only then it can hold larger size of data. That is called register. Register will fetch the data. Register will communicate between data memory and CPU. PC will communicate between instructional memory and CPU. Now, register will communicate between data memory and CPU. These registers will take the data from the symbol table and it will communicate to the CPU in order to do the sum of two number or addition process. So this register status also will be maintained here. So these all activation record consists of address of the next instruction to be executed. Next, status of flags and registers and registers. Minimum, I'm telling. So these all are packed together. This packing is called record. This packing or this packet, where it will be kept? Yes, is packed together. Now the third memory which I mentioned, the stack memory, comes into the picture. This packet is pushed. Now activation record is given to the another memory which I said, stack memory. Now stack memory comes to the picture. Now here registers are communicative. Here PC is communicative. Here registers are communicative. Used for communication with C. That's all you should know. So now this activation record is pushed onto the stack. It is available within the stack. You can imagine if I want to draw, I need to go somewhere. The moment I do the drawing, it will take me to somewhere. Okay, I think so, it is visible. Now, stack memory, how it is available? See, this is the stack memory. It is, imagine that this is a stack. Now within that stack, activation record, very first activation record, whichever you created, you can activation record one. What is activation record one? It is meant for your first function call. Whenever you see a first function call, activation record one is created. One. It will be pushed onto the stack. Then once the second function, before even returning from this function call, if you have one more function call, then what will happen is you will have activation record 2. You will have activation record 2. Understand this concept. That's all. You need to remember this first. After this, I am just saving and closing. See, desktop. This is not recovered. Anyway, desktop. This line, forget about that line. So activation record 1, 2. When activation record 1 is created is while your first function call is seen. While your second function call is seen, this before even returning. Now in this scenario, look at here. This will create activation record 1. Now look at before returning, after I1, I'm going to call function next. I'm going to call function next. This is my next function. So when the next function comes to the picture, I need to take a jump. Function next is here. So here function next, I am having instruction 1, instruction 2. No more 2 for me. I want to return back. Now this return is, while executing this return, what it will do is, the moment it sees a return, it will go to this stack. Within the stack, it will fetch the activation record 2. Then it will fetch and unpack. When it unpacks, it can able to see status of the flags and registers. Then looking at these all information, it comes appropriately to this line, I2. It will come back to I2. Yes, I2 is executed successfully. One more return has been seen here. The moment it sees this return, it goes back to the activation record. It will pop this content. Anything you are doing with the stack, it is called as push and pop. Placing activation record into stack memory is termed as push operation. Taking out from the stack memory is termed as pop operation. Now it is taking out the activation record 1. The activation record 1 will have this all information. With that support, it will go back to I1. Sorry, where it has come? Yeah, this function, this return will go back to I5 and I6. This is how internally the call transfer are handled by the compiler design concept or the control of memory. That's it. So these are all the stuff you may need to understand. The runtime environment is the structure of target computers, registers and memory. This is what I was talking about so far now. This one line only I was addressing. So internally, how the computer registers are functioning, memory is functioning, that you should know. How it serves to manage the memory and how it maintains the information needed to guide your program's execution process. That's all. This is what definition for runtime environment. So the last class, I just created this example scenario. I deleted it. With that only I introduced. Now first analogy we have seen, then only we are seeing definition. I just quickly recap. So internally, while your program is executed, how to manage the internal memory is called runtime memory management. The RAM has several compartments. Instructional memory, next is stack data memory, next is, instructional memory, data memory, stack memory. These are all the three memory majorly I discussed right now. So number one, when you look at instructional memory, it is loaded with set of executable code or machine code. You have a special component called program counter inside of your computer, laptop. Everybody's processor has this program counter. The role of program counter is loading the address of the next instruction to be executed. The role of PC is to communicate with the instructional memory and the CPU. It will fetch the data from the instructional memory and feed to CPU. So PC only can communicate with the CPU. So PC stands for program counter. Next, coming to data memory, otherwise you can understand in this way, all your symbol tables have been created into the data memory compartment. Who will communicate to this memory? Registers only can communicate to this memory. The role of registers are to fetch the data from this memory and communicate with the CPU, or used to communicate with the CPU. Similarly, whatever CPU gives back as a result, if you imagine C is equal to A plus B, C is holding the answer of A plus B. CPU does first A plus B, that value is carried out by register and it will fetch back to or store it into the data memory. Vice versa, register will have bidirectional communication. That part you should remember. So after that, where this activation record concept comes is stack memory. Stack memory is meant for holding activation records. It will work in the manner, or it will work in the philosophy called push and pop, or lost in first out. whenever function call invocation, function call, simply for function call, whenever function call is there in a program, activation records are created. That activation records are pushed onto the stack. Whenever the return statement is available, the activation records are written. Whenever return statement is available, popped. Activation records are popped. During the function call invocation, pushed. Activation records are pushed. This you should be in the position to understand. So now let us see here now. Heap memory, extra memory. Right now I am not addressing. Later I will address. Look at here. There is a main function. Instruction 1, instruction 2, 3, 4. Execution. Subsequently, there is a function call, alteration in the flow of program. The moment it sees the function call, activation record or frame pointer, this is a technical jargon, that's all, has been created. What this does, it holds the address of the next instruction, status of flags and register. It will pack it together. That packing is called activation record. The moment the activation record is created, it will be placed onto the stack memory. Since that is the first function call, first activation record is created and it is placed onto the stack memory. Yes, it is placed here. Next, the alteration of the program execution is continued here. Altered. Now, no more execution of this instruction. The flow of control is transferred here. Now it will execute I1. Now there is one more deviation. We are forcibly directed to function next. Now activation record is created. In this junction, activation record 2 is created. 2 is created. Now the moment it is created, it is pushed onto the stack. Now come here. After that, I2 instruction is executed. It comes here. The control is coming here. I1, I2 is executed. It sees the return statement. There is a high connection between return statement and the stack memory. Whenever in your programming you see a return statement, it goes to the this stack memory. It starts popping out the topmost content of the stack. So it pops this activation record 2. Then it pops, then it unpacks, then it understand what is the next instruction to be executed, everything. Then the control comes here. Then it sees the return, second return. The moment it sees the second return, the control goes to the stack memory. It looks at the top of the stack. The top of the stack is holding activation record 1. Then this will be popped out. Now it will unpack that activation record. Then using this return, it is possible to reach this location, I5. Then this moment onwards, the normal flow of execution happens. This is how internally the runtime storage management is maintained. So now you can understand the definition. The runtime environment is a structure of the target computer's registers and memory, and that serves to manage memory and maintain information needed to guide a program's execution process. That's all. Now let us look at the types of runtime environment. 1 minute, then we can wind up the session. Fully static, one method. Stack based is one method. Fully dynamic is another method. These are all those three major types. What is activation record? We understood right now. Look at here. Information needed by a single execution of a procedure is managed using a contiguous block of storage called activation record. Whatever the information recovered, all those information is needed or stored in the activation record. Activation record is allocated when a procedure is entered and it is deallocated when the procedure is exited. Instead of procedure, function, I said. When a function is entered, any function is entered and it is deallocated when that function is exited. It contains temporary data, local data, machine status, optional access link, optional control link, actual parameters and return value. I said very few for your understanding. These all, finally, you need to understand how much information it is packed together. Now look at here, program counter whose value is address of the next instruction to be executed. This also will be available. Stack pointer whose value is the top of the stack. Stack pointer is always used to point top of the stack. Frame pointer is always used to point the current activation record. All these together only it is termed as activation record. What is activation tree and what are all the types of runtime environment? We continue in the next class.